thing about Islam, like one time I gave this advice to a youngster, because his mama passed away, man, Allah bless him. She was like, my son, I'm gonna take Shahadah. So I asked him, he said, well, y'all got too many rules. I said, nah, man, so one rule in Islam is, don't do wrong. As long as you got that, it's good. So basically, you know, we believe that there's only one God, and that's Allah. He's by himself. There's nobody else. No, nothing in the creation of the worship outside of Allah. He's God Almighty. And then we believe in his angels. We believe in his prophets. The last prophet being the prophet Muhammad, but we also believe in Jesus. Like a lot of people who were saying the other night at Tarawih, the Quran has a chapter that's named for Jesus' grandfather. So like even a lot of Christians don't know who Jesus' granddad was. You know what I'm saying? His name is Imran. So we believe in Jesus, and then he was a prophet and a messenger. We believe in Moses, we believe in Abraham, and we believe the culmination of that was the prophet Muhammad. And if you saw all of something, if we believe in the books, we believe in the Holy Quran, we believe in the Bible. You know, we don't believe that the Bible is, you read the King James version. King James ain't got nothing to do with that. But we believe in, like the brother said, the classic, the Injil, the Torah, was revealed to like Jesus and Moses. And we believe in the Psalms, the original version. And then we believe that the culmination of that is the Holy Quran. And the Holy Quran, the Arabic Quran, is the only one that's untampered. So the same way we reveal to the prophet is the same way we have to reveal. And then we believe in, help me out, the books, the Kaaba. So we believe in God's will, right? So whatever happens to us, but we think we might have been bad or good, you know that if God didn't want it to happen, it wouldn't happen. So if everybody wanted to line up and give you something and God didn't want you to have it, it wouldn't happen. And if everybody wanted you to have something and God didn't want you to have it, if God wanted you to have something and everybody else was trying to prevent it, so, with that, those are the basic beliefs. We believe in the last day. We believe that you should be resurrected. So, those are the beliefs. You prove it all, though. And then the action is the first one is what we're about to do is to take Shahadah. You bear witness to your way out of the lives and Muhammad's blessing you. And you want to pray for 5 days of prayer. And you know, so this is a work in progress. We brand new Muslims. Some people, soon they become Muslims, they start praying 5 times a day, but usually that's because they're incarcerated.
Some of that's true. Yeah.
We want to do 5 prayers and the fast and the month of Ramadan. And all of these have rules and little ins and outs that you learn, you know, and we have a package that we're gonna give you too, with some food and stuff. And then you wanna make highs if you can afford it, because it's going to Mecca, and then paying your annual cap, which is on your savings. So if you have a savings of more than $400, then 2.5% of that savings after a year, gives away to the children. And so that's the basic practice. So as long as you do those beliefs and those practices, you good. And the main thing is your testimony and faith. Like we can all fall short and this act and that act, but as long as we still believe there's no God from the top behind the present, we're still good. So that's what we'll do. So well, I'll give you the mic, and then I'll say it, and then you just repeat. Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Wa
ashhadu.
Wa
ashhadu.
Wa ashhadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Rasulullah.
Rasulullah.
Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashhadu.
Wa ashhadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Rasulullah.
Rasulullah.
Ashhadu.
Ashhadu.
Allah.
Allah.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Illallah.
Wa ashhadu.
Wa ashhadu.
Anna.
Anna.
Muhammadan.
Muhammadan.
Rasulullah.
Rasulullah.
So right there, the English says, I bear witness. And I bear witness,
I bear witness
that there is no object worthy of worship.
There is no object worthy of worship
except Allah.
Except Allah.
And I bear witness.
I bear witness
that Muhammad.
That Muhammad
is the messenger of Allah.
Is the messenger of Allah.
Tabir
Allah.
So that, so you know, back when the prophet said something was born, that would be the way people would come and they would take it. And once you take that, it changes your life. Because you start to look at things differently. You know what I'm saying? And so, and it's really a freedom that you get from the Shahadah that you can't get from anything else. And when people, they go through their life looking for something to give them that freedom, and at the best, they might get them temporary freedom. So they'll see a card and they really like, oh, this is what I need. But then after a while, the card gets straight, and then they're like, oh, this is what I need. You know what I'm saying? But that Shahadah is never going to wear out. And once you start learning things like Sukhubatiya is the only thing you can say over and over and over again, and it never gets old. Like, if your favorite song from 10 years ago, you can't listen to them every day now. Hear it once in the top of your head, but then that's it. But so, you know, stay with your brothers and sisters who brought you out. You know what I'm saying? And then I'll put it in the middle.